Hello and a very warm welcome to Saurav Sir's classes. Today's tutorial will be on accountancy. This tutorial will focus on journals. In case of any query, you can contact us on this number. And if you wish to know more about us, you can check in our website. Now let us first define what do we mean by journal. Okay, so the definition. Then we will look into the format and the steps for preparing the journal entries. So there are three parts. So let us define it first. So a journal is called a book of prime or important entry. Now the process of recording a transaction in a journal is called journalizing. Okay, here the definition of journal in. Now we are in this tutorial we are also providing you terms that are associated to journal, like journalizing. So this process is called journalizing, the process of recording. And what do you mean by journal entry then? So an entry made in journal is called a journal entry. So we are defining the terms using very simple words so that it is easy to understand. So these are the three words we have defined here, all related to journal. One itself is journal. Now let us look at the format of journal. Okay, so it looks something like this. You have a column for date, then you have particulars, then you have a ledger folio, okay, that is LF. And why this is required and why we are writing ledger folio here? Because when you post entry to your journal, the next step is to transfer them to the ledger. So that's why we are writing the ledger folio, so that in future it becomes easy when we are transferring it. Okay, now in the next column, you both the columns you have amount. However, the second last column is the debit and the last column is the credit. So this is the format of a journal. Now the last part, we move on to the last part, is steps for preparing journal entries. Now let us look at the steps. Now first, a statement will be given to you. So you have to identify, this is step one. Step one is to identify the statement that whether it is an event or transaction. Now if at all it is a transaction, so if the statement is a transaction, this is step two, then only you will proceed for step 3. So the moment you realize the statement given is an event, you will not go to the next step. Okay, so once you have, you know that it is a transaction, you move on to step 3. Now we will see what are the tricks to identify whether a transaction given to you is a cash transaction or a credit transaction. So let's see. So if in a particular sentence the name plus the cash, say $5,000, $6,000, anything is mentioned, then it becomes a cash transaction. Now in a particular sentence, say the number name of is mentioned plus the number is also mentioned in a sentence, then it becomes a cash transaction. Okay, then if the number name of a plus cash is also mentioned then in a transaction, then it becomes a cash transaction. And if the name of a person is mentioned and number cash is mentioned, the word cash is not mentioned but the number is mentioned, say only 5,000, not 5,000 cash, then it becomes a credit transaction. So I hope this short tutorial on accountancy was helpful. If it was, please hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, share our videos, and thank you so much for watching.